So in this lecture, now we will write down what is Fermat's theorem and see some problems related to Fermat's theorem. So let me state the theorem. Let A be some integer and P is a prime number. Such that P should not divide A, or you can even say that the GCD of P and A should be 1, then according to Fermat's theorem, A raised to P minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo P. This is Fermat's theorem. So I will take A to be an integer and P is a prime number, and P should not divide A. P should means A should not be divisible by the number P. That is, the GCD of A and P is 1. You can check any one of these conditions. Then according to the Fermat's theorem, we can say that the P minus 1th power of A, that is A raised to P minus 1, will be congruent to which number? It will be simply congruent to 1 modulo P. Okay. For example, if I take A to be 7, A to be 5 and P is a prime number, which I'm taking 7, clearly we know that P does not divide A, means 7 does not divide the number 5, or the GCD of 5 and 7 is equal to how much? 1. Then by Fermat's theorem, I can say that A raised to P minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo P, means I'm substituting the values. 5 raised to 7 minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo P, means 5 raised to 6 is congruent to 1 modulo 7. Okay, this is the conclusion from Fermat's theorem. If I take the integer A to be 5, and if I take the prime number equal to what? The prime number was 7. Okay, this means that by the definition of congruence, this means that 5 raised to 6 minus 1 is divisible by this number, is divisible by what? This number is divisible by 7. Or I can even write in the language of divides, that is, it equivalently means that 7 divides 5 raised to 6 minus 1. So we will start with the problem on Fermat's theorem. So I will divide 13 raised to 73 by 11 and find remainder. Using Fermat's theorem. So here the number A that I'm going to consider is 13, because that's the base of the given number, and the prime number that I'm going to consider is 11. So P is 11, and we know that 13 and prime have no common divisor. So the GCD of 13 and 11 is going to be how much? It is going to be 1. So I can apply Fermat's theorem. So by Fermat's theorem, I can write A raised to P minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo P. So this means that 13 raised to 11 minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo 11. Okay, and this is nothing but 13 raised to 10 is congruent to 1 modulo 11. Now we want the 73rd power of 13, correct? So we actually are having a target of 13 raised to 73. So the nearest power that I can get from this thing is that I have already 10th power. So if I raise both the sides by 7, I will directly reach the 70th power. So raise both sides by 7th power. So I will get 13 raised to 10 raised to the 7th power is equal to 1 raised to 7 modulo 11. So this will become 13 raised to 70 is congruent to 1 raised to 7 is 1. So it is 1 modulo 11. Now I want the 73rd power. So what I will do is I will multiply both sides by only 13 for the time being. I will not multiply both sides by 13 cube because 13 cube is a very large number. So when I multiply both sides by 13, I will go step by step, multiply by 13 both sides. So I will get 13 raised to 71. When I multiply the left hand side by 13, on the left hand side, I'll get 13 raised to 7. It's congruent to 13 modulo 11. Okay, and in modulo 11, we know that in modulo 11, 11 becomes 0, so 12 becomes 1, and therefore 13 becomes 2. So this 13 actually can be replaced by what? This 13 is a very heavy number, so I'm going to replace that 13 by just 2. So it is 2 modulo 11. And this is 13 raised to 71. So once I understand that 13 is equivalent to 2, now I will multiply both sides by 13 square directly. So multiply by 13 square, what will I get? 13 raised to 73. So I'm getting two powers will be added. So this will be 2 into 13 into 13 because it is 13 square modulo 11. And again, we know that modulo 11, 13 and 13, 13 is congruent to 2. So this 13 can be replaced by 2. So I will have 2 into 2 into 2 modulo 11. I could have initially at the very starting step when I got the 70th power of 13 there itself, if I multiply by 13 cube on both the sides, then I will get on the right hand side 13 multiplied by 13 multiplied by 13. And every 13 will be replaced by what? Every 13 I could have replaced by 2. So that is also fine. So I just did one step extra so that you will understand. Slowly we will make the right hand side. We will always try to reduce it and make it small and keep it as a number which is below 11. That number should not go above 11, because if it goes above 11, then I will bring it down by taking its modulus. Okay. So this will be 2 into 2 into 2, which is 8. So the right hand side will now become 8. 8 modulo. So now I got a number on the left hand side which is below 11. So this number is below 11. So this statement actually tells us that when I divide 13 raised to 73 by 11, the remainder that I'm going to get is what? The remainder that I'm going to get is 8. Okay, let me do one more problem. I'm going to divide 3 raised to 99 by 7 and I'm going to find the remainder. So here for this problem, I will take a to be 3 and the prime number is 7. So a and p have GCD 1. So there is no common divisor between 3 and 7. So the GCD is 1. So I can apply Fermat's theorem. Which tells me that a raised to p minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo p. So that is 3 raised to 7 minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo 7. So this means 3 raised to 6 is congruent to 1 modulo 7. And I want the 3 raised to 99th power. So I have to reach as close as possible to 99. So if we raise both the sides by 16th power, we will reach 96th power, raise by 16th power. So I will get 3 raised to 6, raised to 16th power is congruent to 1 modulo 7. And this will become now 3 raised to 96 is congruent to 1 modulo 7. And therefore I will multiply both the sides by 3 cube, because 3 cube is a small number. 3 cube is only 27. So I will multiply both sides by 3 cube. So I will get 3 raised to 96 into 3 cube is equal to 3 cube is 27 modulo 7. And this will mean that 3 raised to 90 is 9. Is congruent to 27. Now what is 27? 27 is a larger number than 7. So I will have to reduce it. Okay. So we know that if I reduce 27, 27 can be reduced. We know in modulo 7, 7 is 0. 14 is also 0. And 21 is also 0. Correct. So 27 is how much in that case? So divide 27 by 7. So we will get it 6. So this means the answer is how much? 27 is nothing but 6. So 27 can be replaced by what? 6 modulo 7. And this statement means that if 3 raised to 99 is divided by 7, the remainder will turn out to be how much? At the end step, don't forget to write the remainder. So the remainder is how much? The remainder in this division will be equal to 6. Okay.